Party.
Greetings guys, this is Dopecraft and today I am going to show you what the BDR can be capable of in a tier 7 match on Ruinsburg on Fire. It's a 58% win chance for our team and I am heading off in the BDR towards this central part of the map right here. I think that on this map you have got to take the middle, actually, because in the city you're pretty much closed off and I don't think that this side of the city here is really capable of dishing out the tanks on the other side of the city. But back to the BDR. The BDR is a pretty bad tier 5 tank in my opinion. It is really sluggish, it is a really big target and has no armor at all. The gun capabilities are really weird as well. The accuracy is not really good. The aim time is not really good. It has a really big, long reload time. But there's a reason for that. Because this tank carries a 90mm with an alpha damage of 240. The highest alpha damage in tier 5 on a normal tank. That is a really good amount of alpha damage and that's pretty much the only thing that stands out of this tank. So, meaning that this tank is not really good with armor, mobility, that sort of stuff. It is a support tank in my opinion. That's what I'm doing right here. I'm waiting at the back, and especially because this is a tier 7 game, I don't want to be the frontline tank because we are engaging tier 7 tanks. Okay, get spotted. Look at the aim time and at the accuracy of this gun. It hits though, but I aim for, 2 seconds, 2.5 seconds, and my shot still goes up to the right. But if the BDR is capable of getting these side shots, then it's not really a problem. Then this alpha damage is really nice indeed. Well now, T29 and an SU-122-44. No problem. Shot in his ass. Good effort. I want to kill the SU first because that thing is really dangerous. There we go. And it is 6-6. No, 7-6 for our team. Side shot of the turret. I couldn't see the hull of the T29, so I tried to penetrate his side of the turret. And I managed to do it, so that's pretty nice. I've got almost 1,000 damage in a tier 7 game, which is a really good effort, of course. But the game is not over. We are 3 tanks in front against the enemy team. And the enemy team are running around in the city. And there is one tiger still on the field here. So, the tiger takes one guy out and another guy. And then another teammate gets taken out. And the scores are pulled back to 9-9. So I'm starting to get a little bit worried. Put a shot into the tiger, but then the tiger gets obliterated. From all his health to nothing. Also, the pretty good player on our team, the Hellcat, died. Unfortunately, the M5 Stuart died early in the game. But that does not matter. I'm the only alright player alive now, but that doesn't say anything. Of course, stats don't say anything. But I am the only yellow player alive on both teams. And the enemy starts to cap. I've got 1212 damage on me, which is a really good effort, of course, in a tier 7 game. I would be thrilled, even in a tier 5 game, to have over 1000 damage. It's a good effort, but we're not done yet. Because look at the setup of the enemy team. We've got a Tiger, another Tiger, a KV-85, an M6, and a KV-1 against us. And now the scores are pulled back to 10-11. It's not a good shot in my opinion, but now I try to side scrape him out. Which is a lucky bounce actually. That was a lucky bounce because this thing only has 440 side armor. And I managed to bounce a Tiger, which has 200mm of penetration. So that's a really, really good effort for me there. Oh, I just missed the Tiger there. But there's an M6 who's showing his side armor, no problem. And then another 2 teammates get taken out. And I am alone with this Comet who also picked up 4 kills. But now I get tracked and I am thinking, Shall I repair? Shall I repair? Yes, I'll repair. My drag gets taken off again. And my repair bag's gone for this game.
Allons-y.
Luckily my drag gets set back on, but then the comet goes on a suicide run. I tried to pull back or halt, but he goes on a suicide run against the tiger, which of course doesn't work out. Well now, I have to think about where the enemy tanks are. I want to kill them one by one by one by one. Tiger isn't spotted, and there gets the KV-85 spotted behind me. I drive forward, dug into some cover, don't give him a chance to aim at me. But I have to take a shot. I can easily take a shot because I'm still at full health. Luckily he misses me, which saves me a lot of health of course, but I have to make this shot count because otherwise he will be able to put another shot into me. Doesn't matter, he's down. Nice, shot goes perfectly where I ended up in. But then I see think about the KV-1. I was trying to turn around to think when he was coming the other way, but he wasn't. I put a shot through his drive wheel, immobilizing him and damaging him, of course. The KV-1S has got the 122mm mounted and is putting high explosive shells into me. But doesn't matter, he gets taken out. I'm on. And now the Tiger realizes how dangerous this situation is and how well this BDR is playing, so he left the cap circle. But then I get another lucky bounce from a Tiger and take him out. So, that's a Top Gun medal for me, and 2,700 damage in a tier 7 game. Not too shabby, but we've got a really dangerous situation now. I don't know how much health the enemy Tiger is on, and he is not a foolish player because he's picked up 4 kills as well. So this time my side scraping doesn't work, he gets spotted and I get surprised. He puts a shot into me. He comes after me, I'm trying to side scrape him again. Thinking that I could penetrate this, but unfortunately it doesn't. And I'm loading my premium now, but I'm realizing it's too late. Yeah, we're not bouncing this. Well, still I felt like that I had a really good game in the BDR. This was a really, really good game for this tank. 2,700 damage according to XVM and a Top Gun medal in a tier 7 game. Not too shabby, guys. So let's now take a look at the post-game stats. So guys, this was a Ace Tanker badge for the BDR in this game. We picked up a Ace Tanker badge, a Fire for Effect token, and a Bruiser token, and we picked up the Top Gun medal and the High Caliber medal for this game. We did 2,718 damage, got 6 kills, and got 855 base experience. That might not look like a lot, but guys, this was a defeat, and when you lose, you get 50% less experience than the team who wins. So in fact, 50% plus this is around 1200 basic speed if this would have been a win. So that's of course an Ace Tanker badge for this game. There's also one other good advantage at the BDR which I didn't mention in the game, and that is that the BDR is a really good profit maker. As you can see, we made almost 19,000 credits profit for this game. We have also spent a lot of money on repair packs, on ammunition, and of course on repairing our tank. So this is the best money maker in the game, which isn't a premium tank, if you would like to know. So if you want to get some credits collected, get the BDR. So guys, this was the video. I hope you liked watching me play in the BDR and really seeing that even low tier vehicles can be capable of having monster games in higher tier games, of course. Leave a like if you enjoyed, because I did put a lot of time making this video. I hope you still like this video, and I'm sorry for the lack of content during the past weeks, but I am really busy at school because the holidays are coming and I have to work really hard before the holidays. Further content of the test server is coming up. I am busy of it, but I was having problems with my recording programs all the time, but hopefully that will be fixed soon. and if it doesn't, then I'll let you know. Guys, I'll see you next time.